When most of you think of World War II, you probably don't think of Mexico, though this vast Latin American country contributed labor and lives to the Allied cause, and Mexican sacrifices certainly don't get the attention that they deserve. Here on the front, we're all about reviving those lesser-known stories of war, and in this video, we're reviving the story of Mexico in the Second World War. So hold on to your tacos. As with all things in history, it's important to understand the context of the time, and for this video, it's especially important we understand the basics of the relationship between the US and Mexico preceding the latter's declaration of war. If the Mexican-American War some 100 years prior wasn't enough, the fact that Mexico, under their reformist president, Lázaro Cárdenas del Río, nationalized their oil industry just a year before the start of the war certainly made the Yanks a little crabby. Though, there's more to it than that. Like many countries, those of Latin America had no problem trading with the Germans, before the Germans sunk their ships or otherwise poked the hornet's nest. In saying that, trade routes between Europe and Latin America were disrupted by the war in Europe before Mexico broke relations with the Axis powers in the wake of Pearl Harbor. So it's fair to say they had nothing to lose making it official. Also, in light of these same trade route disruptions, Latin America had no choice but to rely on the US for trade, so breaking relations with, and later declaring war on the Axis was as much of a move to strengthen Mexico's relations with the US as it was to stand up to the fascist threat. On Mexico's declaration, it was announced formally, after German U-boats put two Mexican oil tankers, the Potrero de Llano and the Faja de Oro, under the waves in the Gulf of Mexico in May 1942, and didn't apologize for it. See, it always involves bloody oil. In 1942, Mexico's next president, Manuel Ávila Camacho, who took the mantle from Lázaro Cárdenas del Río in 1940, made it compulsory for able young Mexicans to get some military experience, though he emphasized they wouldn't have to go overseas and get shot, only contribute to material and learn how to shoot someone else, in the case war ever made it to home soil. President Camacho later gave some ground, however, allowing the US military to conscript Mexican nationals living in the US, and it's estimated that between 15,000 and 30,000 of Mexicans in said circumstance were drafted into the US military, with some of them volunteering their service in return of citizenship. Of these almost 15,000 to 30,000, 1,500 became casualties in some capacity. Also, it's important to note that between 250,000 and 500,000 Mexican Americans, US citizens with Mexican heritage, fought for the US military in World War II. Wishing to place his own pieces down on the wartime strategy board, earn himself a seat in post-war negotiations, and keep Mexican civilians invested in the war, President Camacho mustered the Aztec Eagles, the sole flying arm in what became the Mexican Expeditionary Force, in July 1944. As we've covered in a previous video on its contribution to the war, Brazil was the only other Latin American country to muster an expeditionary force. Back to Mexico, the Aztec Eagles, officially known as the 201st Fighter Squadron, was, you guessed it, an Air Force fighter squadron, and it was Mexico's only expeditionary unit to fight alongside the Allies in the Second World War. While the squadron was composed of 307 volunteers, only 30 to 31 of them were pilots, while the remaining 270 were ground support crew. On the 24th of July 1944, the Aztec Eagles started training in a US airbase in Texas and continued training at that and various other bases for around 3 months before moving on to Major's Field for advanced combat training. By February 1945, the squadron had graduated from Major's Field, and in March, the unit was en route to the Philippines, arriving in Manila at the end of April and being assigned to the US 5th Air Force's 58th Fighter Group, which was based elsewhere on the island of Luzon. From there, the squadron was in the air quite a bit, First in borrowed craft and then in Republic P47D30RA Thunderbolts, totaling over 1,900 hours of flight and flying in over 90 combat missions. Of those 90 missions, 43 were ground support missions for the US 25th Infantry Division, 37 were additional training missions, 4 were fighter sweeps, and just 1 was a dive bombing mission. While fighting in the Philippines against the Japanese, 5 Aztec Eagle pilots lost their lives. And bear in mind, this was around 1/6 of the squadron's total pilots, and a further 3 perished in training accidents. Despite this, the Aztec Eagles put some 30,000 Japanese out of action, though this wasn't just the pilots. Those ground support troops, they got some blood on their hands too. In 2003, retired Aztec Eagles pilot Carlos Garduno Nunez was part of the Mexican Association of World War II Veterans, which by that year had just 10 living members. In an interview with American Forces Press Service reporter Rudy Williams, Garduno said, "I joined the squadron of Aztec Eagles because, as a professional military man, I was dedicated to serving my country. Professional men have to accept the call of duty." Garduno also noted, in those days, Mexico still had a tremendous resentment toward the United States for the Mexican War and the American occupation of Veracruz, so about 90% of Mexico was against cooperation with the United States. As small as Mexico's contribution was compared to the big nations, it was very significant. Regardless of past conflicts we had with the United States, the important thing is to be together as we were in the Second World War. Unity, cooperation, and integrity for our beliefs and freedom are the important thing. Miguel Moreno Arriola, another Aztec Eagles veteran, concurred, saying, "We're very proud to have served with the American veterans in World War II." While the Aztec Eagles are deserving of far more attention than we have time for in this video, two of Mexico's greatest contributions to the Allied cause were its labor efforts under the Bratero program and its efforts in what came to be known as the Mexican Miracle. The Bratero program was an incentive of the August 1942 Mexican farm labor agreement between the US and Mexico, which basically allowed Mexican laborers to work on farms in the US for a whopping 30 cents an hour, without having to worry about being drafted into the US military. Some 300,000 Mexicans labored in the US in 1942 alone, though the program actually continued for almost 20 years after the war, and this, of course, gave rise to some pretty controversial issues. As for the Mexican Miracle, Mexico stepped up its game to provide more cadmium, copper, graphite, lead, mercury, and zinc to the US than any other country in Latin America, and this raised Mexico's industry to unprecedented levels. It was both a miracle for the US, who were sorely in need of raw materials, and Mexico, which under President Camacho was able to pay off foreign debts, pay workers more, and otherwise improve Mexico's economy. While it was indeed jump-started in World War II, the Mexican Miracle was realistically a period of economic growth lasting from the 1940s to 1970. Mexicans worked for and died for the Allies, but it was Mexico's cooperation with the US which mustn't be forgotten, especially given the tension between Mexico and the US today. Up to 30,000 Mexicans fought alongside US soldiers under the US military in World War II. Up to 500,000 US soldiers with Mexican heritage fought for their old land and their new one. Mexican pilots touched wings with US pilots all through the Philippines, and those Mexican pilots, at least veterans like Carlos Garduno Nunez and Miguel Moreno Arriola, were proud to have done so. Despite the controversies of the Bratero program, Mexicans still answered the call, and without Mexican industry, the US may never have been able to sustain its voracious military production. Though, what do you think? Were you aware that Mexico even participated in World War II? Do you think Mexican contributions weren't all that significant? Do you think the Bratero program caused more problems than it solved? Please let us know in the comment section below. And just before you go, guys, as usual, make sure you check out some of those links in the description. If you want to get a full detailed guide on all the sources we used in our script, we post it on our Discord channel, and on that channel you can actually interact with other history fans such as yourself as well. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you learned something new.